I couldn't think of a more appropriate day than Martin Luther King Jr. Day as a day of service and a day of investment and reinvestment in the community. We're here to talk about College Bound today, and I would like to defer to the mayor for him to talk a little bit about College Bound and what it's meant to him and his city and my city. And then I wanted to thought we could have a little bit of a conversation casually just about Baltimore and where we are, where we're headed, and where the state of Maryland's headed, and the Orioles, how the Orioles fit into that as best we can.
So. Thank you, John, and good morning, everyone, and happy MLK Day to everyone. And first, let me thank John and team at the Orioles for always being a true a partner to the city of Baltimore. I always say that there are sports teams that are in cities and sports teams that are of cities, and the Orioles are in the latter. They are a part of Baltimore and a deep part, especially for me. As everyone knows, I want a World Series championship more than anything in the world, but we'll talk about that in March. But today we're here to talk about the Orioles and continuing to grow their already deep community support for our residents here in Baltimore, for our young people in Baltimore. And today we're talking about an organization that means the world to me, the College Bound Foundation, because were it not for this organization, I wouldn't have been the mayor of Baltimore, because I probably wouldn't have went to St. Mary's College. Well, I for sure wouldn't be able to afford going to St. Mary's College and getting my political science degree. But when you think about College Bound, an organization that was actually started by Mayor Schmoke many, many, many moons ago to support young people and families in Baltimore financially when they're going off to college, something that we know when you come from neighborhoods like I came from in Park Heights, or like my fellow Mustang alum and board chair Alicia Wilson from East Baltimore, we know families here in Baltimore struggle to make that need. It's not that young people in Baltimore don't get accepted into these colleges, that they're not able to handle the workload. The finances is always one of the biggest things for them. And we know we don't want them taking on hundreds of thousands of dollars of debt. So the College Bound Foundation grants out scholarships and awards over $1 million every year solely to Baltimore City students. We do a lot of that through our Last Dollar Grant programs, which is a match program in schools across the state of Maryland. But what the Orioles are doing now, John, I think we're going to talk about this more. It's really not just an investment into the organization. It's an investment to the future of Baltimore. Because when you see what College Bound alum do, they come back home. They are teachers, they are lawyers, they are mayors, they are doctors, they are nurses, they are police officers. They are the folks who work in our city and our community every day, and they're able to do that because College Bound allowed them to take the SAT for free, took them on that visit to school, showed them how to work through all the issues on dealing with college applications, work with them through college to make sure that they stayed, because as our motto is, it's to college and through college, right? This organization changed lives for so many families. It's not just about what it did for me, but for my little brother. It's about what it did for my friends, giving us the opportunity that, quite frankly, we wouldn't have had otherwise. So it's an organization now as a board member that I'm always going to support because I know how important the work is.
No, that's right on target, I think. And, Martin Luther King said it's not the color of your skin, it's the content of your character, but it's also the resources that just through happenstance or good fortune or not as good fortune, your family or your community can provide. And people just need a helping hand to, as the mayor said, get into college and then stay the course and get through. And, we're at a great moment, I think, in the future of the city and the state. We have great leadership, I think, not only in the mayor's office. I know the mayor and I are both excited about Governor-elect Wes Moore, who's a friend, and coming into the governor's office. And the Orioles are also on a cycle here where I think we're going to do great things, not only between the lines because of the management team that we brought on board, but also what we're going to do in the community. And we're going to do a lot more. A long, long time ago in the 60s, a little before I was born, Mayor Scott mentions former Mayor Schmoke, who's a friend, and at University of Baltimore, where my father named the law school after his parents. For anybody who wants some clarity, that's not me, that's my grandfather. And before Mayor Schmoke was mayor, before Mayor Scott was in the city council. My father was in the city council, and it's hard to believe, especially if you're some of the younger students who may be here today, it's hard to believe that when my father was in the city council, he was part of an effort to sponsor legislation that would do away with segregated accommodations, bathrooms and water fountains and such things. It's hard to believe that in our lifetimes that was ever a thing, as the kids say today, right? So, but it was a thing, and the way that we ensure that it's never ever a thing again and that we take this community and this society in a different direction is investing in educating in the best and the brightest, irrespective of their background or their color of their skin or their race or what nationality they come from. And the way that we do that is by reaching across the aisle, or in this case, probably more on the same side of the aisle. But but I'll tell you what, can I say something about across the aisle? Because, and I don't know how the mayor's going to feel about this. He probably knows where I'm going. Oh, well, why don't you?
Nope, you got it.
Okay, well, the mayor and my wife Margaret and I went up to Williamsport, Pennsylvania for the Little League Classic, and we spent a couple minutes laughing at all the one-liners from former President George Bush. And I never met George Bush, and I don't know if the mayor has. And, you know, I have my views on different people from different parties, but I'll tell you, that's the way it should be, where we reach across the aisle and are arm in arm and take pictures together, and you have a former president who's perceived to be a Republican, whatever that means, and a conservative, and you have the sitting mayor of Baltimore, and then you get me just along for the ride trying to introduce people. So that's what this country's about. That's what it's going to be about. That's what this city's about. This city's not about what they say. It's about its true history of ethnic diversity, a melting pot, and an opportunity to bring people together. That's what College Bound is about. I have to admit, I didn't know that much about College Bound. I'm shocked at how many people universally and uniformly speak glowingly of it, in addition to the mayor. And, you know, the mayor went to Mervo and I went to Gilman, and those are a little bit different parts of town. And but we're all part of the same town. And if we can make investments in these types of programs and bring these labels, because that's all they are, you know, Democrats, Republicans, elephants and donkeys, those things are meaningless. It's about people to people, and it's about programs that reinvest. We want to put hundreds and thousands more young Baltimore people into college, as the mayor said, keep them through the, stay in the course, and get them to graduate. And if some of them come back and one day are the president of the Orioles, that would be really good, right? But whether that happens or not, it'll be so good for the community. And it's important to not be divisive. It's important to be reinvesting, and that's what we want to do at the Orioles. So, we're going to talk more about the city, I hope. I do want to end the suspense, though. I really honestly didn't know what would make a difference. And I think what would mostly make a difference is if we are collaborative with the mayor's office and College Bound and work with the state to try to get as much support as we can. And so I picked a number because I think about what the work my dad did, the work Mayor Schmoke did, the work that Mayor Scott's doing and others. And the Orioles are really honored on Martin Luther King Day to commit $5 million to the College Bound group, which we are gonna work constructively with the mayor and with everyone involved to pledge that and infuse that over however few or however many years that makes sense to the effort. So if we do that $1 million a year or 200,000, whatever you want to do, we want to do. And I really do appreciate the mayor bringing this to my attention.
No, thank you, John. I think Cassie almost fell out of her chair, so we know the number is spot on. And it's really for me, because when I think about that, I think about those graduations. I think about that young student who might be about to graduate, and they're short, in College Bound able to help them get over that hump. That person who needs that counselor or that cap inside their high school to show them how to go through the college application process. All of that matters, and this investment that you all are making into the future of Baltimore through College Bound would undoubtedly change the course of our city. And I'm going to predict that some of those young people will come back to work for the Orioles in some sort of management role, and we'll be winning the World Series every year, so the Yankees will continue to lose it, which is the best thing that happened.
But
really want to thank you for that investment. It is truly, truly, truly appreciated, but also, again, shows the deep commitment that you all, your family, the Orioles have, you have for the city of Baltimore. So we are very grateful. Thank you very much.
Can I thank you, Mayor, for saying so. Can I just say also that we and we've talked about this a little bit, and this is part of, I think, the how we work together to curate a program that's meaningful. We're fortunate at a pro sports team that has so many events, 162 game schedule, 81 home games. We have lots of entry level jobs and we've worked with the Youth Works program in the past. We want to continue to find and stream kids from this area who need summer jobs, who need opportunity, who need something to add to their resume, and get them on the grounds crew and in the event staff and taking in the box office, with the hope that then as they get into the college ranks and get through the college ranks, we will have a corporate internship program that will allow them to get work and work study as they're getting their education. And then, yes, we would like the pick of those who work the hardest and do the best. But that's not why we do it. And I just think that's inevitable. Someone starts here, someone continues, someone goes to college in the state of Maryland, and they become mayor, or they become president of the Ravens or the Orioles or what have you. That's a great story, and that's a story we should make happen.
No, thank you. And I think, we talked about this a lot, too, about the internships and folks that can grow. I came to City Hall as an intern, and now I'm the CEO. So we know that's how it works. And knowing the young people that we have, not just the ones that we have today, but those who we have in high schools throughout Baltimore, I know they will be chomping at the bit to come and work at the Orioles, even if it's only for a semester or a summer.
I count it a privilege that I've been able to be at two announcements. I was able to be at the announcement when the law school was named after your grandfather and your grandmother. And on this day when you've made such a magnanimous gift to College Bound Foundation. I'm just overwhelmed. I almost cried when I heard the number about your really investment in hope for Baltimore. So I'd love to give you the opportunity to talk about why you keep betting on hope in Baltimore, and why all of us who could be anywhere and doing anything at this day and at this time should be motivated to just build upon the great hope that I think all of us have in this city and its people.
That's a really great question, and I hope we have hope, and I guess I would say what's not to like, right? I mean, I think one of the problems we've had in Baltimore for a long time is we have a hard time with our own elevator speech, right? And this is leadership. This is the most sophisticated business people, political people. Well, so many of us, and I've done this too probably, but I just try to get out of the habit. We start by saying two or three negative things about the city, and then we say, but we have these things. Well, I think we all know in our business lives and our personal lives, just leave the first two or three things out. Just start with the but. Even if you have to use the word but Baltimore's great, but Baltimore's wonderful. Now, when people much smarter than I took a chance in the 80s and developed Harbor Place and developed Camden Yards, it's interesting to think the kind of vision, the kind of perspective that those people had. It's interesting to think that the Harbor Place went to a public referendum and Camden Yards went to a close vote of the legislature. What would the city have been without that? Well, the city would have been great without that. But those inspirational ideas that come out of hope created some anchors, created some pillars, created some excitement. That led to the Ravens coming. That led to this complex. I hope it's going to lead to this complex being developed. And I'd like to see this complex, this whole campus developed, not just with shopping and high-priced condos and
office buildings and so forth, but with community services, with mentorship, with tutoring. Why couldn't you have a public school right here in some form? I mean, logistically, that might be a challenge. But why can't you say, why can't you have hope? This is an East Coast city, right between the nation's capital and New York, Philadelphia, prime part of the world. It's got a great, great history. It's had great people. And we can build on this when
David Bramble rebuilds
Harbor Place. It won't just be the Jim Rouse thing with nothing else. There's not a lot around it. It'll be the David Bramble Jim Rouse thing with all these other things around it. And when we renovate Camden Yards and the Ravens do Raven Stadium, these are big ideas. This is legacy type stuff. But it doesn't work unless you reinvest in the residents, in the people that mean the most, in the best and the brightest who just don't have a chance. Well, we're gonna try and give them a chance. Well, we're just one baseball team. But it's all about partnership, it's all about bipartisanship, and it's all about perspective. So I see what they're doing in Detroit, I'm happy about that, but I'm from here, I live here. I'm gonna hope and pray and bet on this city, and I'm not gonna stop.
Last question, please, anyone? Nathan?
Mayor Scott, how does an investment like this on the Orioles' behalf make you hopeful for the future things you and the team can do in this city?
Well, I think this is, as I said before, this is the continuance and growth of an already existing partnership, right? The Orioles already do so much for our young people in the city. They actually help even train our Rec and Parks staff to how to do the fields and upkeep. So if you've been playing on a Rec and Parks field and feel like it's been better over the last couple of years, it just shows what's possible. And what's possible, not just as you heard from John, in a one-time thing, but an ongoing thing. This is not them just giving the $5 million, but committing to remaining a YouthWorks partner, committing to building in internships for college students that can ultimately help change the trajectory of neighborhoods and families across the city. So we're very grateful. They have always been a deep partner as long as I've been in City Hall, and that's going on 16 years. And now you're seeing that partnership grow and deepening at a time when we know it's much needed in our city.